He was described as a throwback to the days of the Flying Frenchman, playing with reckless abandon, a kamikaze on blades. Hockey observers analyzed Glenn Anderson's exciting style in many ways. But above all, Glenn was Mr. Clutch, a playoff titan. Glenn's blazing speed was symbolic of the Edmonton Oilers' 1980s dynasty. Anderson lunged and crashed at the net frequently, doing whatever it took to score a goal. Glenn had tremendous balance on his skates, even with NHL defenders draped all over him. He was simply one of the NHL's greatest ever big game players, helping the Oilers to 5 Stanley Cup titles. He earned a 6th ring while playing with the New York Rangers in 1994. During the Oilers' prime in the 1980s, Anderson consistently resided near the top of the NHL scoring leaders. However, his real value surfaced in the playoffs, where he scored overtime winners and game-clinching goals in each of the Oilers' 5 Stanley Cup winning marches. Anderson's greatest success came as a right winger on a line with Marc Messier.
He scores!
The two fleet-footed skaters perfectly complemented each other as members of the most prolific offensive team in NHL history. On a team of sharpshooters, Anderson thrived mightily, surpassing 100 points on 3 occasions and finishing with a plus-minus rating of over plus 40 3 consecutive years. In the playoffs, Glenn scored 93 goals and added 121 assists for 214 points in 225 playoff games. 17 of his playoff goals were game winners. Anderson's 3 playoff overtime winners still stand as an Oilers record. For such an outstanding sniper, Glenn Anderson did not immediately warm to the game of hockey. Born in 1960 in Vancouver, Glenn hated the 6 a.m. ritual of going to the rink while growing up in Burnaby, B.C. Anderson was craftily selected 69th overall by GM Glenn Sather in the infamous draft of 1979. But Glenn dreamed of gold medals, preferring to put his NHL ambitions on hold in favor of the Olympics. This personal goal also worked nicely with Glenn's desire to see the world at a young age. After joining the Canadian national squad, Glenn traveled with the team throughout Europe and Asia to prepare for the 1980 Winter Olympic Games at Lake Placid, New York. Anderson scored 2 goals and 4 points in the 1980 Olympic tournament. Glenn eventually made his NHL debut the next year, making an immediate impact in the big leagues. In just 58 games, Anderson found the net 30 times, sparking comparisons to some of the game's greatest performers, including the flower, Guy Lafleur. With his carefree attitude away from the rink, Glenn's Oiler teammates called him Mork. The nickname alluded to the zany Robin Williams character from the hit television series Mork and Mindy. After Anderson was named Player of the Week by the Hockey News late in the first season, his teammates stopped calling him Mork in favor of Andy. Anderson really hit his stride in the 1981-82 season, scoring a career-high 105 points on 38 goals and 67 assists. Glenn's status as an NHL superstar was solidified the next year when he potted 48 goals and 56 helpers for 104 points. Glenn began his playoff heroics in the spring of 1983 when the Oilers made their first run at the Cup, scoring 10 goals and 20 points in 18 games before Edmonton lost the final round to the powerful New York Islanders. With the Oilers emerging as an NHL force, Anderson gave netminders around the league nightmares. Skating with hockey icons like Gretzky, Curry, Messier, and Coffey, Glenn Anderson and the Edmonton Oilers proceeded to rewrite the NHL record books. In the 1983-84 campaign, Andy scored a career-best 54 goals, totaling 99 points in 80 regular season games. Glenn fired 6 goals and 17 points in 19 games in the spring of 1984 as the Oilers hoisted their first ever Stanley Cup. The Oilers had matured together, a close-knit group of players who eventually became known as the Boys on the Bus. This was a team of warriors, with Anderson the anointed game-breaker, the reliable one. The Oilers turned to Anderson when they desperately needed a goal, and inevitably, number nine would come through. Being patriotic at heart, Glenn didn't hesitate when he was asked to don the maple leaf at the 1984 Canada Cup. Playing with several of his Oiler teammates, Glenn did his country proud as the Canadians took home the gold. In the 1984-85 season, the Oilers continued their dominance in every aspect, especially on offense. Anderson finished with 42 goals and 81 points in 80 games. Then Anderson perhaps had his strongest playoff in the spring of 1985, scoring 10 goals, 16 assists, and 26 points in 18 games. The Oilers repeated as Stanley Cup champions and were on top of the world. The next year saw Glenn miss 8 games, but still equal his career best of 54 goals while adding 48 assists for 102 points. Anderson fired 8 goals in 10 games during the 86 playoffs, but the Oilers suffered defeat at the hands of their provincial rivals, the Calgary Flames. Glenn's offensive prowess continued the next 2 years as he scored 35 and 38 goals, both of which saw the Oilers win the Cup. Anderson averaged a point a game in the 1990 playoffs, scoring 10 goals and 22 points in the 22 postseason games. The Oilers surprised some pundits by winning their 5th Stanley Cup in 7 years. Anderson spent the first 12 years of his career wearing Oiler colors before being dealt to the Toronto Maple Leafs in September of 1991. Traded to the New York Rangers in 1994, Glenn was reunited with his pal, Mark Messier. Moose, Glenn, and Kevin Lowe each sipped from the cup for the 6th time as the Broadway Blueshirts won their long-awaited Stanley Cup. Glenn spent the remainder of his career playing for European teams, another stint with the Canadian Nationals, and short terms with both the Oilers and St. Louis Blues. He finished his NHL career with 498 goals, just short of the magical 500. He added 601 assists for a total of 1,099 points. Glenn's 214 career playoff points stands 4th all time, while his 93 goals ranks 5th all time. One of the great international players, Glenn skated in the 1980 Lake Placid Olympics, 2 Canada Cups, 2 World Championships, and the Rendezvous Tournament of 1987. With 5 of his legendary Oiler teammates already enshrined in the hallowed hall. An elite member of the Hockey Hall of Fame.